Hi everyone, I'm Mary with Mary Greeley News. Thank you for joining me. Yesterday there in Iran, there was a major earthquake, a magnitude 6.1 earthquake, which USGS downgraded to a magnitude 5.8. This is the second earthquake that was a magnitude 6.0 or greater in the last 24 hours that USGS has downgraded. Buildings have collapsed there. People have been injured and killed there. And I believe the reason they downgraded this earthquake is because earthquakes this year have increased by at least 4 to 5 more a month than last year. On the USGS website that keeps track of earthquakes, magnitude 6 or greater is listed as only 57. If you add in the two that were not reported that were downgraded by USGS, it would be 59 so far this year, and this is April 19th, 2021. Last year, there was only 124 earthquakes of a magnitude 6.0 or greater, an average of about 10.3 earthquakes a month. This year, there's an average of 14.75 earthquakes a month of a magnitude 6.0 or greater. I have been reporting to you that you're going to see an increase in earthquakes and volcanic eruptions around the world, and this is one of them. On the USGS website, 88 people reported it to USGS. Did you feel it? EMSC doesn't even have it listed. On Twitter, there's a post to a YouTube video showing buildings that have collapsed, people running for their lives. I'll give you a link to that. Another Twitter post on the earthquake in Iran. You can see the dust from the hills. It says that there is no damage, supposedly, to the Bushehr nuclear power plant. Yeah, look at the dust that got kicked up from that earthquake. Amazing. USGS has a red alert about fatalities. And here they're showing, what, between 1,000 to 10,000 people, maybe fatalities? Another Twitter post from Bandar. Yeah, look at all the rock slides that are occurring over there. And another Twitter post showing people rushing out. They do scan over to the mountains where the rock slides are occurring, right over there. Yeah, you can see how the ground, from the faults, from the shaking. Another Twitter post showing the damage, the collapsed walls of many of these homes. And another Twitter post, we got broken water lines more likely, power outages. So this earthquake was a strike thrust earthquake. This blue line drawn out is the Zagros fault zone. And zooming in, we can see how far it is from the Bushehr nuclear power plant right there. The moment tensor ball. Here you can see the first wave of the earthquake came from the northeast. Tension was applied straight up. Yeah, this is a thrust earthquake. Geoscope has it listed as a 6.0 earthquake. It was probably a 6.1. Here you can see the fault line as it moved southwest, dipping down, and then the other fault line rising up over it, going northeast. Different scholarly papers talk about this fault zone. It moves about 10 millimeters a year. It's a right lateral fault zone that they used to think was inactive. Yeah, main thrust now inactive. Yeah, I don't think so. Yeah, did someone create this earthquake? I would not be surprised if Iran is not going to blame Israel. Earthquakes are increasing around the world. Here's a location of all the recent earthquakes within the last week on USGS. Here we have that 5.8, actually 6.1 earthquake. There was a 4.4. Another 4.4, a 4.3, a 4.6, a 4.2, and more recently in the same location, a 4.1. So what are your thoughts? Please put your comments down below. Thank you for watching. Always be prepared for a disaster. Please stay safe, and I will talk to you later. God bless you all. Bye.